Green Ranger Shredder rises and fights everyone, and it's awesome. What's up, everyone? James here, and the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles meet the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers in this video. Make sure you hit that like button. So we just got done covering Godzilla versus the Power Rangers, which I'll have a link to at the end of this video. If you enjoyed the fun in that series, you'll also enjoy the fun in this one. So this opens with the Power Rangers doing their usual thing of battling the Putty Patrollers and Rita's Monster of the Week, Apocalyptopus, a mollusk humanoid monster terrorizing Angel Grove. I have to say the artwork by Simone Di Meo is stunning. I love it. We learn through the Rangers conversation that Tommy isn't here fighting alongside them, and we'll find out why soon. Jason calls for the Rangers to form the Power Blaster. Each one of them pulls out their individual weapon and form the blaster. They wipe out the Putty Patrollers and Apocalyptopus. We then go to the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, who are doing their usual thing of battling the Foot Clan. I like how Simone draws a slight difference in each of the turtles' headband, not only making the color of each of them distinct from the other. I also like how the foot ninjas look menacing. As the turtles are trashing them, Raphael grabs one of the foot here, and the ninja strikes him with a roundhouse to the face. Raph takes his mask off in the process, and this ninja is revealed to be Tommy. Raph regains his footing and tries to strike back, but Tommy puts him down. This shocks the rest of the turtles because usually the foot ninjas, besides the elite, are nothing but scrubs. Tommy says, "Clan on me, ninja vanish," which I swear is a callback to the OG film. After they disappear, even Mikey is like, "Did that guy just say ninja vanish? They usually just do it." Donnie and Mikey make fun of Raph, saying that he just got shoryukened. Mikey names Tommy Ultra Foot Ninja Steve. So I expected, like Godzilla vs. the Power Rangers, that these two teams in this series would meet because of some multiversal shenanigans. But turns out that is not the case. This confirms that they are part of the same universe. This is actually not the first time these two properties met or were part of the same universe. It was in Power Rangers in Space and the episode Shell Shock, where they crossed over with TMNT the Next Mutation. The weird thing about that episode though is Raph referred to the Power Rangers as not being real, referring to them as comic book characters. But when the Rangers met them, they knew exactly who they were. At the command center, Kimberly asks Zordon and Alpha if they've heard anything from Tommy. Apparently before he left, he told the Rangers and Zordon that he had to handle some quote, family stuff. And no, he is not related to the Shredder, that's not going to be revealed here. Even though, that would be insane and cool. But the reason why Kimberly is worried is because he's been gone for a few weeks now with no communication. Zordon and Alpha try to reassure that he's fine, since they haven't gotten any spikes in the morphing grid of him morphing. Zordon assumes he just wants privacy, but Zordon tells her should he morph, he'll send them to his location. In New York, Tommy meets with Karai. For those of you who don't know, Karai is dangerous. You'll see that firsthand in this video. In some universes, she's depicted as the daughter of the Shredder, or the daughter of Hamato Yoshi, Splinter's master, or just a high-ranking member within the Foot. My favorite version of her is from 2003's TMNT series. Karai tells Tommy that their master, the Shredder, is impressed with his actions against the Turtles, and since he's joined them. It's because of this he has a special task, but before it's given to him, he has to answer the question of what is it he wants. Tommy answers, "I want more. Everyone in my life has tossed me aside, and the world takes care of everyone but me. I want to join the Foot, a place where people come not only to survive, but fight for what's theirs." Later that night, Tommy sets out on his mission, which is to break into Mason Technologies and steal a power cell that will play a major role in this series. What's pretty funny is after he successfully reaches the tech, he finds the Ninja Turtles are already there waiting for him. They all end up like grading him on his performance. When they go to attack him, Tommy says, "Dragon Zord," and morphs into the Green Ranger. Now, what confirms the Turtles know about the Power Rangers is Mikey says, "No way, Steve the Ninja is a Power Ranger." Tommy takes on all the Turtles. Look, Power Rangers definitely have a list of advantages over the Turtles. Like, if this was evil Green Ranger Tommy, I love the Turtles to death, but this would be a bloodbath. And just to be clear, I'm talking about standard Turtles, not the different iterations that have gotten more powerful in the shows and comics. Also, this is Tommy holding back, because he tells them that he doesn't want to do any permanent damage to them. So in this fight, he is just doing his best to dodge and evade them. Raph gets his licks in and lands a blow on Tommy, just paying him back for earlier. Now, because Tommy morphed, the Rangers get his location. When they arrive on the rooftop of Mason Technologies, that's when Tommy gets thrown through a wall, landing in front of them. This shocked me a bit because it shows that the Ninja Turtles are vicious. Here's where we get the fight between Turtle Power and Go-Go Power Rangers. The leaders go head-to-head, Leonardo and Jason. When they clash, Leo is like, "Nice sword," and Jason replies, "Thanks." The geniuses of both teams fight. Donnie is just asking Billy questions as they fight. He asks, "So are you guys aliens? Are your powers supernatural based? And oh, how does the green dude play a flute through a faceplate?" Which is a genuine question, I'll say. How, Tommy? How? Kimberly confronts Tommy on what's going on with him. Tommy doesn't answer her question, he just tells her he did his best not to get them involved, and that he needs to leave now, but asks her to trust him. She reluctantly does, but Raphael tries to prevent him from leaving, and so Kimberly stops him. She says to Tommy, "Go, we've got him." Raph responds to this saying, "What's this we? Your boyfriend is leaving, sweetheart." Then boom, Trini punches him in the face, saying, "She was talking about me, sweetheart." Now from a nearby rooftop above, Karai and the Shredder watch the Turtles and Rangers fight. Now the Shredder apparently knew already Tommy was the Green Ranger. Karai reports to him that Tommy successfully escaped with the tech, but asks him why he didn't tell her he knew Tommy's identity. He responds, "Confidence must be earned. If all goes as intended, the Power Ranger will be mine to command." Though the Power Rangers have superhuman abilities, the Turtles are holding their own against them. I mean, lest we forget, their mutation did give them enhanced strength, which is why they can overpower beings 10 times their size. Not to mention the fact they've been training literally since birth in ninjutsu. That definitely gives them the skill advantage over the Power Rangers. Now, the Power Rangers had assumed that the Turtles were Rita's monsters, but during his fight and conversation with Donatello, Billy figures out they aren't monsters. He tells the other Rangers, and Jason calls an end to the fight. They all end up leaving together when a Channel 6 news helicopter arrives above them. We see April O'Neil reporting on the footsteps of the tech at Mason Technologies and the Power Rangers being spotted. The Turtles bring the Power Rangers to their home in the sewers. The Rangers end up revealing their identities and introduce themselves to them. April shows up and meets them. The funny part is that Zach is like, so are we all gonna just ignore the giant rat sitting in the corner? Splinter ends up introducing himself, apologizing for the Turtles fighting them, and asking how they can help those who have helped so many. Meanwhile, at the Foot's base, the Technodrome, the Shredder meets with his forces. Tommy's offering to him of the tech he stole qualifies him to join the Jonin Foot Elite. The Shredder accepts it and honors him with the rank. He says, "From this moment on, your abilities serve to further our cause. Your life is mine." Now, this is where it gets revealed why Tommy joined the Foot. Sometime later, as the Foot ninjas are training, Tommy pulls one of them aside, and this ninja turns out to be a childhood friend named Tyler. Tommy reveals to him that his dad, Richard, called him, informing him that he had gotten mixed up with a martial arts cult, so he joined the Foot in order to find him and save him. Here's the problem. Tyler doesn't want to be saved. He defends the Foot and tells Tommy he hasn't seen him in years, and expecting him to just up and leave with him isn't happening. Tyler, at that moment, electrocutes Tommy, incapacitating him. This was all expected and planned by the Shredder. Tyler makes Tommy his offering for the Shredder, which he accepts and gives Tyler the rank of the Foot Elite. Now, thanks to Kimberly and April working together to find anything on the Foot, they were able to find and track down their training center using a photo a kid posted online of a ninja star. While they're looking for more info, Donnie and Billy are working on a morphing tracker. The rest of the Turtles and Rangers head to this hideout and come crashing in together. As they're fighting the Foot, Mikey and Zach discuss their favorite pizza toppings. When Zach says pineapple, Mikey replies, "Pineapple on pizza? Dude, gross." Which is so true. Pineapple on pizza is heresy, I tell ya. The absolutely hilarious thing that takes place is during this fight, Jason and Leo are taking on Karai. And I wasn't exaggerating when I said she's dangerous. She's given them a hard fight. But the funny thing is, when their fight is at a standstill, Leo and Jason argue about how to engage her further. Jason is like, she studied Musashi. Leo replies, you have to use a Jigen Ryu attack with your sword. Jason says, too chaotic, she'll cut me in half. Out of nowhere, Karai gets hit in the head with a teapot. Trini says to both of them, just hit her in the head, guys, don't overthink it. So after they beat the foot and restrain them, they question Karai about where Tommy is being kept. She only tells them that he is with the Shredder and they are already too late. That's where we go to next, Tommy awakening in the cell, being confronted by the Shredder. Now Tommy initially tries to feign ignorance, but Shredder tells him to dispense with the pretenses. He knows who he is and why he is here, because his friends at Dimension X are well versed in the Power Rangers. Now Dimension X is a parallel dimension in the home realm of Krang in this universe, another one of the Turtles' main villains. That could be the friend Shredder is referring to. Tommy replies, well, your friends should have warned you, picking a fight with us is a bad idea. He morphs and challenges Shredder. Shredder says, another time perhaps, and activates this device using the power cell Tommy stole and unleashes a massive blast on Tommy that demorphs him. He thanks him for the demonstration of how to use the morpher. You all know what this is leading to now. At Rita's Moon Palace, she senses someone has her Dragon Power Coin and mentions that she feels a shift in the morphing grid. When Finster and Goldar offer to go retrieve the coin, Rita insists on getting it herself because she senses the new holder of the Power Coin is someone powerful. They transport to the Technodrome and are met by Bebop and Rocksteady. Now Squat talks some trash here, saying these guys are uglier than them. When Rita says, you're not the one I seek, that's when Shredder approaches, telling her that he was warned she might interfere. Rita says, I don't care who you are, return my Dragon Power Coin or I will melt this monstrosity to the ground. Shredder replies, Dragon Zord. He morphs into the Green Ranger and says, I am the Shredder, and if you want this coin, by all means, you're welcome to try and take it. The Shredder versus Rita Repulsa goes down and it's amazing. These two clash, and Rita becomes enraged because as she points out to Shredder, he corrupted the Power Coin. Shredder says, I merely bent it to my will, as I do all things. I've never felt anything like it. The speed, strength, and raw power. It's intoxicating. My senses are like razors, and my muscles are like steel. The world slows, yet I do not. He gains the upper hand in his fight with Rita, knocking her back. At the same time, Goldar is fighting Rocksteady, while Finster, Baboon Squad are hiding from Bebop. The fight between Rita and Shredder becomes even more intense. Rita regains her footing and says, you are not the first to be seduced by the Power Coins, Ninja. Your greed will be your undoing, for I have defeated far greater than you. Shredder replies, I have broken one Ranger, and soon I will break them all. Will you stand by my side or in my way? Rita responds, I have only ever been on one side, human, my own. They clash and this huge blast occurs around them. After it dissipates, Shredder admits to Rita that she is formidable, that his allies in Dimension X were right about her, and had mentioned they both can do great things together. So they both decide to work together, but Rita isn't letting Shredder slide so easily. She says, once we're done destroying our enemies, you and I will finish this dance of ours. Shredder replies, I would expect nothing less, and in fact, I look forward to it. Later, we see Tyler visits Tommy's cell, and through their conversation, we learn Tyler and Tommy grew up together in an orphanage. Tommy assumes he is just being mind controlled, but Tyler makes it clear he isn't and tells him that he wasn't born lucky like him. Tommy immediately fires back, asking how could he be born lucky when they grew up in the same streets and have been fighting the same fights together since they were 7. That's when Tyler reveals the real reason why he betrayed Tommy. It was because he felt betrayed by him when he got adopted and left him. While he was in sunny California, as he puts it, he was here in New York still trying to survive. So it's really the feeling of betrayal along with jealousy. He explains that the foot gave him strength and purpose, as well as people who will always watch his back. Tommy responds that he risked everything in order to track him down and save him, but now he doesn't even know who he is anymore. At the Turtles' lair, Zordon and Alpha contact the Rangers and informs them that they've located Tommy. The Turtles ask the Rangers if they want them to tag along, but they answer they think they need to handle bringing Tommy back alone. Once they reach this location, they split up. Trini and Kimberly already have a feeling this is a trap. From a distance, they think they see Tommy, but when he turns around, it's revealed to be the Shredder. He blasts them back and forces them to demorph. The rest of the team arrives and he blasts them and demorphs them. Jason tries to morph, but the Shredder is like, "Nah, son, that's not happening." He says, "Don't bother, this won't last long." He takes on all the Rangers and takes them out one by one. Honestly, I really wish we saw him fight them first in their Ranger forms, so we can see him dominate them on an even playing field and get a repeat of the beating evil Green Ranger Tommy gave them in the show. That would have been badass. Suddenly, Casey Jones appears and lands a blow on Shredder. He introduces himself to the Rangers, but the introductions don't last long because Shredder crushes him and the Rangers. While being surrounded by his foot ninja, Shredder tells the Rangers to give him their power coins, and all this will end. Realizing they have no way to win this fight, the Rangers run for their freaking lives. But before they make their escape, Shredder informs them if he doesn't possess their power coins by sunrise, he will execute Tommy. When they teleport away, Shredder contacts Rita and reports the Rangers are powerless. She may begin the plan. In the middle of Times Square, Rita sends one of her monsters, Wildfire, along with her putty patrollers, and the chaos begins. At the command center, the Rangers see this and are informed by Casey on who Shredder is. When Jason tells Zordon they can't morph, Zordon informs them that Shredder hit them with a molecular disruption field that's affecting their DNA. The power coins are still active, but they can't use them. Since they need to be at two locations at the same time, one team stopping Wildfire and another saving Tommy, Billy suggests a radical solution. The Power Rangers hand their morphers over to the Ninja Turtles and April. The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and April O'Neil will become the Power Rangers. That's the end of the video. If you want the end of this series, make sure you comment below. In the meantime, check out Godzilla vs. the Power Rangers right here if you haven't seen it. Also, subscribe to the channel. Help me reach 50,000 subscribers, or if you're listening to this on Spotify, hit that follow button. I would greatly, greatly appreciate it. Other than that, have an awesome day, and always remember every day to go beyond.